Sierra, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I do this everyday makeup look. I'm about to take pictures and I just thought you guys would like to see the kind of makeup I do when I go take pictures. This is literally the school, not work, definitely not doing this for work, but for school, out with the girls, date night, taking pictures. The video might be a little long. Oops. The video might be a little long, but I can literally do this in about 30 to 45 minutes. So if you'd like to see how I get this look, just keep on watching. All right. Hi. So today I'm gonna be taking some pictures for my Instagram, and I haven't been wearing makeup on that page a lot, so I thought I would start doing that today, and I just thought you guys would like to see me doing makeup. Alright, and my skin is like normal to slightly dry, but no matter what, when I wear makeup I get really oily on my nose and my forehead, so I'm gonna be using this Makeup Forever Step 1 Mattifying Primer, and I buy the travel size because it lasts me forever and I never want to spend, I think it's $30 on the big one. So this is what we're working with. And then on the rest of my face, I use the Too Faced, oh my god. Oh, wow, that thing actually works. Okay, does that help? Does it? Maybe I put it too dark. No. This. Oh my god, it's so dirty. But this one. Too Faced Hangover RX Primer. Yeah. Almost out. Basically out. BRB. I'm back with reinforcements. Okay. So there's some in here. I know it. And if you've never done this, you're wasting product, just saying. Oh, I wish I could focus. For help. Hi, me from the future. Look in here. Look at how much primer is left. Alright? Don't get scammed, y'all. So, for that side. Oh, wow, that's definitely too much. I'm looking here because this is where my mirror is at. And I like this for my cheeks because I have some texture there and it just smooths it all out. And if my skin's a little bit dry, just makes it feel so much better when I put my foundation on. So next, I'm going to set, not all of my primer, but the center of my face, my forehead, and my nose with the Too Faced Pour In This Way powder. This is the medium shade. Like, when they came out with the first three shades, this was the middle shade. Ooh, you know what? I have something better, Fenty. This powder is so messy. Do you see the powder coming from it? But it's a little less matte than the Too Faced one. So it's a little better for going underneath foundation. And it smells good. Alright. T-zone is set. Now that I'm looking all nice and ashy, we can go on to foundation. My favorite foundation is Lancome. This one right here. Lancome Tint Idol Ultra Wear 24 hour, and I wear the shade, where is it at? 540 Suede W. 540 Suede W. Yeah. And I love this stuff. For foundation, I usually do about 7 pumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Because I like it to be pretty full coverage and even, and not just make sure that it gets everywhere it's supposed to go. And I like to start blending on the lower part of my face so I can drag it down to my neck. Don't forget your ears, girl. This used to be like my perfect match, but then with Miss Rona, I've been in the house a little long. It's not exactly the regular thing. Alright. This is all blended out, but I like to blend my foundation in probably a little extra for a long time, just so it's really melts into the skin more homogeneous, lasts longer, looks smoother, all that jazz. And I did moisturize my skin and do my whole skincare routine before I started doing this. There we go. Now when it comes to highlighting, I do a couple steps. So if I want something more dramatic, I'll color correct first. Not that I really need it, but this helps my highlight to be just a bit brighter. You don't see my foundation color underneath it. So I'll do it on top of my lip and under my eye, because that's where I want it to be the brightest. I don't put too much highlight on my forehead, so I don't color correct there. And then make sure to pat it in really evenly. Try to spread it out as much as possible so everywhere that I highlight has been color corrected. And it's better to pat and not drag, because that will make it streaky and you'll lift up product, and that's not what we want. Make sure to get right underneath the eye, around your nose. Well, you don't have to make sure. This isn't a tutorial. This is just how I do it. I make sure to get around my nose. Okay. Now we're all color corrected. And then I use the Too Faced Born This Way concealer. What color is this? In Chestnut. And I put some on my chin, my upper lip, my under eye. I put some right there, the bridge of my nose, the tip of my nose. Okay, and I'm gonna let that sit for a little bit because it tends to be more opaque when you let it dry down a bit. So I'm gonna add this contour from Fenty, and this is in Espresso. This isn't really a contour in my skin tone though, it's more of a nice bronze color. Into my nose, my forehead, my jaw, because I'm feeling extra. There we go. And I'm going to start blending out from the bottom up, basically. So the same way I applied my concealer. And when it comes to my under eye, I like to blend the outside edges first and then go in, because I want the center of my face to be the brightest and I want the concealer to be more opaque in that area. Blend it out really well. I'm gonna go to the outside and drag that up to my eyebrow and then go over my eye and then back down to the center. And that's where I want it to be the most opaque, is in like my inner tear duct. Feel free to recommend a brand that you like to buy brushes from. I have brushes from literally everywhere. Morphe, World Techniques, Target, Elf. I got it. That looks good. Now to blend out the contour, I'm gonna take this smaller brush. Be Bella. I got brushes from everywhere. I'm gonna start. Actually, let's see.
Now look, y'all, don't judge my quarantine braids, alright? It's been a struggle out here.
I'm gonna pinch this and just dab it in. Then I'm gonna blend my forehead. I like it to be pretty bronzy on my forehead. I think it just balances out the super brightness. Oh, how could I forget my favorite part? I'm gonna take this Fenty concealer in 385 and I'm gonna put that at the places I want it to be the brightest. That's gonna be right here. Right here. Just gonna drag that to the center a bit. So again on the other side here. And like where I would put wing liner. Just brings my face up so much. And I already have almond shaped eyes, so why not enhance those? Oops, back to the contour. I'm gonna let that sit for a bit. That's a really hydrating concealer, so I can let it sit for a while. It'll matte, dry down or anything. Okay, I need to be looking over here. Out with this first and then go over it with that same stippling brush, but this just lets me pat it in without dispersing it too much. Get right up in there. The smaller the brush, the more precise you can be. I only want this on certain areas. That's really how it's most effective for me. If I try to put it everywhere, it kind of has the opposite effect and washes me out. Just put it in strategic spots. I'm going to blend it out with a sifting brush. I'm sure y'all are wondering, when am I gonna do my brows? Right now. I don't like doing them before my foundation. I think doing them after makes them like have something to stick to. Now if I can find my brush. Got it right here. Spoolie. This will do. And I'm going to use the black shadow from this old LARC palette. This is like a palette, like my first high-end palette that I ever bought when I was first getting into makeup in high school. And I would only use 3 colors. Taupe, sable, and espresso. And now I just use a black for my brows. We've come a long way. And I use powder for my brows because I just find it's more forgiving. I could do more like hair-like strokes, I guess you could say. And I start right under the arch first. And that line. And then I drag the tail out of it because my brows are kind of small. So I give it some extra length. And then I go back to the front. Extend that closer. Someone told me there's a rule on your brows to actually be closer together than they naturally are. So when you do your makeup, you should extend them towards each other as well. There you go. Next. Okay, I'm happy with these brows. So I'm gonna some of this powder into this lid, and then I'm gonna get a bit of the Fenty powder. And what color is this? Butter. This is one of the lighter colors, and it scares me, so I'm gonna mix it. Too Faced powder. So I'm basically just tapping my brush in here and then tapping off the excess into the same lid as the Too Faced. And I'm gonna mix them together. So now it's gonna be very brightening but not too harsh to where I'm getting, you know, flashback or it makes me look white under the eye or anything like that. It's just gonna be nice brightening powder. So I'm gonna take this powder, set my face. Don't forget the neck, the ears, the nose. I'm gonna go to the forehead, set all that. I'm gonna go over the center of my face one more time. And my face, again, just, my skin's like normal to dry, so I don't get very oily. But I just love a matte look. I think it looks just really classy. My bronzer is actually an eyeshadow. I know my chocolate girls can relate. So I'm gonna take this shade right here from the Morphe Dare to Create palette. And I'm gonna be pretty generous with this. There we go. And I'm gonna use that shade and mix a little bit of the pink too. The way I do my highlight, I like it to be pretty bright in the center of my face, on my nose, my upper lip, the bridge. Not so much my forehead or my chin though. Cheekbones, I like it to be a little more subtle. Get under my brows too. Take this Wet n Wild pencil, line my waterline, just love the look that gives me intense black liner. Fierce. My favorite combo is brown liner. This is again from Wet n Wild, by the way. This is Praline from the NYX Butter Glosses. In the center, this is like my perfect nude. A pinky brown shade. That in the center. That's already excellent as is, but because I love gloss, we're gonna go on with the Fenty Gloss Bomb Girl. Oh man, lips look so juicy with this. My lip gloss is popping. My lip gloss is cool. Okay. Now I do wear lashes, but I don't know how to put those on camera. I don't want y'all to see me struggle, so I'll come back when I have those on. Alright, here's the finished look. Ooh, what a baddie. What a baddie, what a baddie. Alright, so thanks for watching. This is my basically everyday routine. Anytime I'm gonna wear makeup, this is the look I'm gonna do. May or may not wear eyeshadow. Didn't feel like it today, but always up for a good lash. Oh, also, lashes are from AliExpress. Do not let these Instagram boutiques fool you. That's where they get them from too, okay? AliExpress, got a pack of 5 for maybe like $2.50, and I always order in bulk because I don't remember how much like each thing costs, but came just like this. Love them. And I save the ends because sometimes, you know, I don't know, maybe I want to do something dramatic, I'll put them on the bottom. But this is the look. Thanks for watching, and please like, comment, subscribe. Okay, bye.